Next is position and proximity sensors. Actually, the position, you already know what the position is. And next is proximity. Proximity means just the presence of nearby object. Okay. So here we are not actually measuring any displacement or other physical parameters, but here we are just finding the position. That is only we are concerned about here. So this type of sensors are called position or and proximity sensors. Okay. So the position and proximity sensors are classified as five. The one is eddy current proximity sensor. The other is optical encoders. In detail, we will discuss about optical encoders later. But for here, for just for the purpose of presenting the introducing the proximity sensor, I am just simply giving a brief idea about the optical encoders here. Okay. So next, a pneumatic sensor, and the next type is proximity switches, and the final type is Hall effect sensors. Okay. So these are the five types of sensors we are going to discuss under the topic position and proximity sensing. Okay. So moving on to the first type, it is nothing but eddy current proximity sensor. We already know that the proximity is just the presence of object, nearby object. Okay. I think it is understandable to you. So coming into eddy current sensor, it is used to detect non-magnetic but conductive materials. It is used for detecting, that is just the presence of conducting material. There is no displacement or pressure or temperature are measuring here, but just the detection, that is presence of conductive material, is finding here. What type of conductive material? It is non-magnetic type. There are magnetic type conductive materials, but here we are concerned about non-magnetic type conductive materials. Okay. You will understand why non-magnetic when you understand the working of an eddy current proximity sensor. Okay. So this is how an eddy current proximity sensor looks like. This entire big rectangle is called a probe, and this is actually the target material. That is, if you want to find the presence of this material, you have to keep it here. So we can simply understand how will it works in detail. So in order to understand, we have to find what actually eddy current proximity sensing is. Okay. For understanding, you can simply say means no, it is nothing but a coil. It consists of a coil, an oscillator, and a detector. Okay, these are the components of a eddy current proximity sensor. So the principle for eddy current proximity sensor is a circular current will induced in a conductor when it is kept at a changing magnetic field. So imagine this high frequency magnetic field as a changing magnetic field. So imagine it is a changing magnetic field. It is not a fixed type of magnetic field. It is a changing magnetic field. Imagine if it is a changing magnetic field. If a conductor, a non-magnetic type conductor, is placed here, a circular current called eddy current will induce in this conductor. Okay. That is the basic working principle of a eddy current proximity sensor. Okay. So based on that, it actually works. So with the help of this oscillating circuit, here it is producing the changing magnetic field. This is inductor and this is capacitor. You already learn it from your 12th standard physics, how a oscillation circuit is working, but it is not required here. You just need to write this is a oscillating circuit, you are producing a what? Varying magnetic field. Okay, the oscillating circuit is connected to the amplitude detecting circuit. So actually the thing happens here is when the magnetic field is changing and target material is placed here, an eddy current will form inside this target material, and that eddy current will produce another magnetic field opposing to this magnetic field. Okay, an eddy current will produce an opposing magnetic field to this moving magnetic field. Okay, so there will be a distortion in this initial magnetic field. So because there is an opposing magnetic field from the conductive material, it will disturb the initial magnetic field. Okay, so the disturbance is measured or detected using this amplitude detecting circuit. This circuit is actually finding the disturbed magnetic field. By measuring this disturbance, this device is actually producing an output from this circuit. So this output will be corresponding to the magnitude of disturbance. Okay, so this is how an eddy current proximity sensor is working. This is a eddy current proximity sensor are inexpensive. The features of eddy current proximity sensors are written here. They are inexpensive, available in small size. They are highly reliable, high sensitive for small displacement. So these are the features of a eddy current proximity sensor. Okay, so coming on to the application, you can see that these types of sensors are actually using in machine tool monitoring purpose, final assembly of precision equipment, measuring the dynamics of a continuously moving target, drive shaft monitoring, vibration measurements. These are the area of application for the eddy current sensors. Okay, so coming on to next type of sensor, proximity sensor, it is called the optical encoder. Okay, you can understand what it means. Optical means it is light, encoding means it is something getting some sort of code is reading. Okay, so from the figure itself you can see a disc, a rotating shaft is just a disc. This type of corded disc is mounted over a rotating shaft which will rotate, and at the one side there is a light emitter, that is LED, and at the other end there is a light detector. Okay, so the principle of working is actually it uses light shown through a corded disc. That is, the optical encoder actually uses a light which shown through a corded disc. The light is actually shown through this, you can see here red lines. The light from the LED is actually shown through this corded disc, and it is tracked the movement, and it is received by the photo detector. Okay, the light from the LED beam is passes through the corded disc. Corded means it is actually manufactured as a corded disc. We are not concerned about the cords, but it is actually a corded disc. So it is nothing but a transparent disc with opaque lines. These are just the corded disc. Okay, so with the help of a corded disc, the light is the nature of light is changing. and it is received with the help of a light detector. So the light detector with the help of phase one means phase A, phase B and reference, it is actually producing a sinusoidal wave as its output. Okay, this light detectors will produce a sinusoidal wave as an output, which is transformed into a square pulse. It is actually doing with the help of some other devices. So the sine wave produced by these light detectors are converted into square waves and given into the counters. Okay, it is simply given into the counters. So which will produce, the counters will count the number of rotation of the shaft, or number of, simply by counting the number of detections of a certain hole or a certain chord, we can simply find the RPM of the shaft, that is the speed or of the shaft. Okay, that is how it is working. And it is also used for, if in between you find you inserted a object here, that is if you insert an object in between the LED and the disc, the sum of the light will not get at the other end, so it means that something is present in between. Okay, so it is also used for finding the position or proximity of a object. Okay, so there are two types of optical encoders which provides digital output as a result of linear and angular displacement. Both linear displacement as well as angular displacement of the objects can be found using this, or sensed using this type of devices or sensors. Okay, so you must know what is the basic working principle of the optical encoders are. Okay, so coming into the next type, it is nothing but pneumatic sensor. Pneumatic, you already know, pneumatic means it is something related to air. Okay, pneumatic means it is something related to air. Okay, so you know it is it will be air plays a important role here. So you can see from the block diagram, just from the diagram you can see the investigation of the presence of object. So this is how the pneumatic sensor works. Actually it is used to measure the displacement as well as to sense the proximity of the object close to it. That is, this device can be used for measuring the displacement of an object as well as proximity of the object. Okay, so so the next point is the displacement and proximity are transformed into the change in air pressure. That is how we are going to explain how it works. That is, this is actually the basic shape of the sensor, and through it there is two types of two or more number of valves, that is air passages. So port A, it is from low pressure air inlet, and port B is air dragged out of port and so drop in system pressure. So okay, these two types of ports are present in this. So this is the first condition and this is the second condition. Left side it shows the first condition, and at the right side it shows the second condition. So from the figure you can simply understand that if there is no material or object at the exit port, this location, if there is no object, the pressure, there will not be any opposition for the air which is coming out. Okay, there will not be any opposition. So in case if we place an object at the exit of the device or this type of sensor, pneumatic sensor, you can find you can find the pressure, it will exert a return pressure into the wall so that the air, the pressure, the air that is coming out will get decreased. So indirectly it is decreasing the exit pressure of this device. So this back pressure is measured using a certain type of transducer or a certain circuit, and this back pressure is calibrated using calibrated, and the location of the object is found out. Okay, that is how the proximity sensor is working. So with the help of this these types of sensors, actually a proximity switch is creating. It is nothing but a small electrical switch which requires a physical contact and a small operating force to close the contact. It is nothing but if it is used in robotic arms. Actually here these are a same device with a different operating mechanism, but you can simply take this a lever operated as an example. Here this red arrow mark represents our finger or our touch, a physical contact. Okay, a small with a small operating force. So when a small physical contact is given at this point, actually the switch contact will come here and a certain circuit will get closed so that it will act as a switch. This is nothing but a simple mechanism to understand how a proximity switches are working. It is nothing but when we touch a certain point, it will open or close some mechanism, some electrical circuit mechanism, and thereby it senses that is it is it the name indicates it is a switch. Switch has only two types of output, either on or off. So if a certain amount of physical force is exerted here, you will get either as a either result, that is you will get on signal or off signal. So with the help of that we can find the proximity or presence of a object. That is, this is a simple basic type of a proximity switch. So I hope it is clear. This is another type. This is nothing but just a magnet based read switch as proximity switch. You can simply see initially this is kept, this you can simply imagine as a strip of wire. This is movable and this is fixed strip of wire. So when a magnet is placed here, imagine a magnet is placed here, this conducting wire will get attracted near to the magnet, but it can only move up to this point so that the electrical contact will occur. Okay, so from this electrical contact, so with the help of this electrical contact, you are actually getting a signal that is either on or off. Okay, so that is how a magnet based read switches as proximity switches. Okay, I think these two are a very simple type of proximity switches. You can simply use your logic to understand what these two switches are. Okay, it's nothing complex here. So coming to the last type of sensor, that is last type of position or proximity sensor, that is called a Hall effect sensor. It is nothing but initially it is used for measurement of displacement and deflection, detection of position of object. I'm telling it is used for measurement of displacement and the position of the object. So it is consists of a thin metallic plate which is powered by a battery. You can see from the figure a DC current is actually given into the thin metallic plate. The circuit pass through the conductor in a straight line. The circuit will pass current, electric current in a straight line initially. If there is no magnet, I am talking the case there is no magnet is present. Okay. So initially, when a plate, a simple conductor plate is placed and at two terminals, if the DC current is supplied, you can see that the current will simply pass from here to here in a straight line. Okay. Okay. The when a suddenly a magnet is placed or a magnetic field is induced introduced at this location, you can feel a certain force called the Lorentz force is acting. That is, when a current carrying conductor is placed in the magnetic field, it will experience certain changes and due to the Lorentz force. Okay. Hence, the due to the introduction of magnetic field, the electrons and poles inside the plate will get separated. That is, electrons will flow into one direction and the poles will flow into another direction, opposite direction. With the help of it, we can simply measure the potential difference between the two terminals of the plate. That is how we are getting the Hall voltage. Okay. So the process of obtaining this Hall voltage is called the Hall effect. Okay, I think it is clear to you. The important thing is the magnetic field and a current carrying conductor with a plate. Okay, so the Hall effect voltage will be produced here. So how it is actually sensing the presence is through, for example, if an object is placed in between, or if an object is placed between this plate and magnet, that is, if the magnetic fields are blocked by this object, actually the magnitude of magnetic field reaches the material will changes. By measuring that certain magnitude of voltage, by measuring that change in voltage, you can simply see or sense that there is a object present in between, or there is an object. So that is how a Hall effect sensor work. You can simply use it as a proximity sensor, or if you can calibrate the amount of voltage produced here by moving a certain standard object through this location, you can find a certain magnitude of voltage and calibrate it to get how much displacement it is producing actually. But it is a little more complicated, but for simplicity, you can simply use it as a proximity sensor. Okay, so it is widely used in industrial automation purposes. Okay, so up to here, your position and the proximity sensor is over. Okay, so first type was eddy current proximity sensor. This is actually your flow chart or a diagram. Next is optical encoders. The other one is pneumatic sensors, and the next is proximity switches, the magnetic type and physical contact type. Okay, and next is Hall effect sensors. So up to here, your position and the proximity sensing is over, but to understand some more physical or nature of working, you have to understand what a velocity sensors are. Okay, this is your today's last topic. There are three types. One is tacho generator or tachometer, both are same. Pyroelectric sensor and piezo electric sensors. These are your three types of velocity sensors, which actually uses different principles. Okay, so you can see it in your syllabus that there are different types of principles are written in your syllabus. That is capacitance, induction, etc. So in order to cover those topics, we have to get into some more type of sensors. That is, one type is a velocity sensor. So tachogenerator is a type of velocity sensor which works on the principle of variable reluctance. Okay, variable reluctance. Reluctance means resistance, or not resistance for a magnetic lines to, or a resistance for something to pass. Okay, that is called a resistance. So it works on tachogenerator is works on principle of variable reluctance. It consists of toothed wheel and a magnetic circuit. This is actually the magnetic circuit, and this is toothed wheel. This is this two thing combined together to form the tachogenerator. Okay, so the tooth wheel is mounted on a shaft or an element on which the angular motion is to be measured. In order to find the velocity of a shaft, we are actually mounting this toothed wheel, the part of this tachogenerator. The toothed wheel is mounted over the shaft. Okay, and the magnetic circuit comprising of a coil wound on a ferromagnetic material. This is actually the ferromagnetic material wound over a coil. Okay, as the wheel rotates, the air, so when shaft, we have to find the RPM of the shaft. So when the shaft rotates, actually this toothed wheel will rotate. So as the wheel rotate, the air gap between wheel, tooth and magnetic core changes. So here the air gap is this distance. You can see here only small distance here. When the tooth rotates, you will get this much distance here. So this is enough to sense a change. Okay, so as the wheel rotate, the air gap between the tooth and the magnetic core changes, which result in cyclic change in flux linked with it. Okay, so I think it is clear. So when a certain conductor is placed in a changing magnetic field, voltage will be induced in that object, and it is according to the Fleming's left hand rule. Okay, so as the wheel rotate, the air gap between the wheel tooth and the magnetic core changes, which will result in cyclic change in flux. That is, when a conductor is placed in changing magnetic flux, it will induce an EMF according to Fleming's left hand rule. So that is the principle used here for tachogenerator, and the alternating EMF generated is the measure of angular motion. Okay, actually the alternate EMF generated here is the measure of angular motion. Okay, so I think it is clear to you. A simple AC generator can be used as a tachogenerator. It is not important, but I just used for better understanding. There is a magnetic field, rotor, slip rings, and then AC voltmeter. When you compare it with a AC generator, you can simply understand if both the objects are working similarly. Okay. So the next is a pyroelectric sensor. It works on the principle of pyroelectricity, that is, which is used for motion detection. That is, pyroelectric sensors are used for motion detection. So it works on the principle of pyroelectricity. The crystal material, that is non-centrosymmetrical crystal, that is a certain geometry of crystal, geometrically cut crystal, generate charge in response to heat flow. Okay, so when heat flow through these certain geometric crystal material, it will generate a charge. Okay, so examples for the pyroelectric crystals are triglycerin sulfate, or ceramics like lead zirconate, or polymer like polyvinyl iodine. Okay, so when heating in presence of electric field, a polarization of this crystal will occur, and on cooling, the material retains its polarization, and in absence of electric field, when infrared rays radiation occurs, the polarization reduces. So we are using actually IR radiation to depolarize the object if needed. Okay, so when coming to the sensor, it consists of a input as a thermal energy. We already told it is used for motion detection. So certain thermal energy will be radiated from a object, and it is passed through IR filter, and then it into a pyroelectric sensor. The pyroelectric sensor is connected to an amplifier and a comparator to get the required output. When the thermal energy of a certain object changes, you will get corresponding output. The amplifier used to amplify the voltage which was produced from the pyroelectric sensor. It will be comparatively small magnitude, but it, with the help of amplifier, it is increasing, and with a certain standard values, already known values, it is comparing and giving a certain amount of output, and the motion is detected. Okay, initial this is already explained here. Publications are intrusion detection detector, optothermal detector, pollution detector, position sensor, solar cell studies, engine analysis. These are the examples for pyroelectric sensors. So coming to piezoelectric sensors, this is the last type of sensor you must know. So this sensor is used to measure pressure, acceleration, and dynamic forces. So these piezoelectric sensor is actually used to measure pressure, acceleration, and dynamic forces. When force is applied on a piezoelectric material, that is, we usually take piezoelectric material as quartz. Okay, when certain amount of force is applied during compression or tension, the charge over the material changes and get redistributes. That is, it is the property of a piezoelectric material that when force is applied during compression or tension, that is, when force is applied in compressive nature or in tensile nature, the charge over the material, that is already, which is already connected to an alternating current, the charge which is deposited over the material changes, and it gets redistributed. The nature of charge or location of charges will get redistributed. Okay, once phase of the material changes, positively charged and the other negatively charged, that is, one side will become positively charged and the other side become negatively charged, the net charge Q on the surface is proportional to the amount by which the quartz have been displaced. So if with a certain magnitude of force, if quartz is displaced with this much distance, that imagine it is as x centimeter or millimeter, imagine it is an x millimeter displacement, you will get a certain amount of voltage or current. Okay, so with the help of this voltage or charge, you can simply find the displacement or the force on the material. Okay, so the equation is Q is equal to K times X, or X is displacement, K is constant, and which is equal to S times F, that is, F is force and S is the charge sensitivity of the material, both for deflection as well as for a force measurement, displacement as well as force measurement, this type of piezoelectric sensors are used. Okay, so this is it, this is your today's topic, and I am winding up my session here.